Everyone, Regal Reviews here. It is White Rice Wednesday. So today I wanted to do my White Rice Wednesday review on fellow Survivor castaway Jeremy Collins. Jeremy was on the season San Juan del Sur, and he was also on the Second Chance season Cambodia, which he actually won, so congratulations to Jeremy for winning Survivor Second Chance. That's such an honor. I mean, it's an honor to win Survivor, but when you get picked by the people, you get in Second Chance. I mean, you have to live up. Your gameplay totally changes, so congratulations for winning. And I gotta say, I wasn't a huge fan of Jeremy on San Juan del Sur. I thought he was a bit too whiny. The first episode, you see him go against his wife Val in the challenge, and he sent his wife Val to Exile Island, and he was like really upset about it. I'm like, you're gonna see your wife again. It's not like you're never gonna see her again. She's still in the game. You're gonna be able to see her again. I just did not get that. And he held a grudge against John Rocker because I'm not exactly sure what happened. I think that he promised to protect Val in the tribal council, and she ended up getting sent home. So that kind of had Jeremy not liking John Rocker then. Jeremy was a physical threat. He was very good in challenges. He was muscular. I mean, he was physically built. He was a firefighter, so he was very strong. He did have some competition though. He did see Josh as a potential threat because of his strategic mind and that he's well liked among the other castaways. So Jeremy thought that he needs to get him out. And as much as I love Josh, I'd love to see Josh or Reed won. I think Jeremy made the best decision for himself at the time. He actually won the first immunity challenge on the merge day, and it was a memory challenge, and his opponent was Josh, and Josh ended up losing, and Josh ended up getting sent home. And unfortunately, Jeremy did not win San Juan del Sur. He was voted out at the next tribal council after Josh, so he got to sit on the jury. But like Survivor Second Chance was all about, I was actually very happy that Jeremy was in the voting pool for Second Chance, because I did think he deserved a second chance. I thought his time on Survivor was cut a bit short, so I was happy to see him come back. And he did play a different game. I was actually pleasantly surprised. He kind of had what he described as his shields to kind of take the attention away that he's a big threat. And yeah, I didn't get why anybody, like, how nobody saw that Jeremy was this big threat in the game. Jeremy was very loyal. He was on the Bayan tribe and had an alliance of Kimmy and Fishback, and they seemed pretty loyal up until a little bit after post-merge. Jeremy was also great at finding idols this season. I mean, next to Kelly Wentworth, he was awesome at finding idols. He found, I believe, two of them, and he actually used one of them to protect Fishback, which I thought was awesome because it showed his loyalty to Fishback and showed how they are in the alliance, and I thought that was so awesome that he played that for him. But the next episode, he voted Fishback out, unfortunately. He ended up using his last idol, in which was a Survivor first when the votes were deadlocked, because Spencer won immunity, and Jeremy and Kelly Wentworth both used their idols, so they were immune to the vote. And there was a tie between Kimmy and Tasha, and they refused to change their vote, so by default Keith would go home. I was like, oh my god, this is like, I'm sitting here watching this is like so intense. It's like, this is, like I said, a Survivor first, but I did not want Keith to go home, so I was kind of happy Kimmy went home. Then Jeremy, you didn't see him as a threat because Joe kind of stole the show a lot because, the golden boy, the show was all around him, and everyone saw Joe as this big threat and didn't see Jeremy as this big physical threat. And Jeremy did okay in the challenges. He actually won a couple, and he actually won the last immunity challenge, which is where it counts. And he got to choose who he took to the end of them, and he took Spencer and Tasha, which I would have loved to see Kelly Wentworth go to the end, but I think he made the best decision for him because Tasha was kind of like a drag along and she didn't really do anything. So basically, you're looking at Spencer or Jeremy, and Spencer, people kind of had mixed emotions about. They kind of thought that he was a bit arrogant sometimes, and I could kind of see where they were thinking that sometimes he could be arrogant, but I think Jeremy did make the best decision. I would have definitely voted for Jeremy if I was on the jury. He gave a pretty sympathetic speech. If you've seen the Loved Ones episode that also showed a Survivor first, when former castaways who've been on the show before got to come back from the Loved Ones episode, and you saw his wife Val running up to him and saying, it's a boy, because he said on the camera that his wife is pregnant. And he was so happy that it's a boy, but he didn't want to tell anybody yet. And he waited until the final tribal council to say it's a boy, and how he wants to do, he wants to prove something to his family, his daughters. He wants to show that he could win this, and he's a firefighter, and firefighters, I don't think make a lot. So if it was me on the jury, I would definitely vote for Jeremy to win Second Chance. So congratulations, Jeremy, on winning Survivor Second Chance, and congrats on your new baby boy. I'm sure you and Val are very happy. I think I was wondering if Val would ever come back on for a second chance, but I think a tweet Jeremy sent to a fan said that the Collins family's done on Survivor, which I thought if they would have another second chance season, Val would definitely be on that because Val's time was also cut a bit short, but we'll have to wait and see. Survivor, the new season, KO Wrong, actually premieres next Wednesday at 8. So if you haven't seen Survivor, or if you're a Survivor fan like myself, I hope you tune in Wednesday, 8 p.m. CBS. Until next time, stay regal.